Hello everyone, welcome back to another beginner Japanese lesson from some guy. Got another set of problems for you today. Before we begin though, as always, please be sure to hit that like button and subscribe. Click that notification bell if you haven't already, so you'll know when new videos are released. Alright, so let's get started with our kanji based problem. So number 58, we have to choose the correct reading of the highlighted word here. So the sentence says, 5時半 ni gakko kara kaerimashita. So how do we write 帰りました in kanji? So pause the video here, choose an answer, and then we'll check. All right, so the answer is 2番 です. 帰りました. 5時半 に 学校 から 帰りました. So I went home from school at 5:30. 5時半 に at 5:30. 学校 から, from school, 帰りました. I went home. And now we're going to take a closer look at some of the kanji characters that we can see in the sentence. And the first one we're going to look at is the kanji character for the number 5. So we use it all the time. You know, for example, like 5月 would be May. And if you're not familiar with how to say the months in Japanese, it's really easy. You just have the number and then 月 after the month. So January would be 1月. February would be 2月. March, 3月, and so on. And if you want to say the date, you can just add the character for day or sun. So here we have 5日, the 5th. So 5月の itsuka, the 5th of May. Next, we have half, 半. Just like we saw in the sentence, 5時半, so 5:30, 6時半, 7時半, 6:30, 7:30, pretty easy pattern. Or we can say, you know, 半分 to talk about half of, you know, some kind of portion. So for example, pizza no hanbun tabeta. So I ate half of the pizza. The next character we saw is the character we saw in school, ko. So we have gakko. So school, you know, shogakko, chugakko, kogakko. So elementary school, junior high, and high school. And if you have the leader of a school, the principal, the kocho, the principal of a school. And last, we have, you know, kaeru, the character for to go home. And this is the same character, the same word that you'll hear in, you know, okaeri nasai. So when you come home from work and you say, you walk in your door and you say, tadaima, you know, your wife or husband or somebody, whatever, might say, you know, okaeri nasai. So welcome home. Moving on now, we're going to take a look at our vocabulary. So our tango, number 59, we have to choose the word that best completes the sentence. So it says, 明日は テストがあるから学校へ行くのが嫌です。ひどいです。無理です。バカです。So how do we complete the sentence here? So pause the video, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is
1番です。いや。明日はテストがあるから学校へ行くのが
So tomorrow we have a test, so going to school is terrible. I don't want to go. So 明日は, so tomorrow, テストがあるから, there is a test. So 学校へ行くのが, going to school, 嫌です, is terrible, or is something I don't want to do. 嫌, something is disgusting or you don't like it. So 嫌 in kanji is written this way, but you'll often just see it in, you know, hiragana. It means you don't like something, or something is rather disgusting, maybe gross, or just unappealing. So we have 嫌なやつがいる. So maybe you want to talk about a person, you can use it as a na adjective. 嫌なやつがいる. There's a person here that I don't like. And next we saw the word hidoi, which means terrible or severe. So we can say something like hidoi ame. So this means that the weather or the rain is quite heavy. We can also say
テストでひどい点を取った.
So on the test, I got a bad score. So 点を取る means like to get a score. So ひどい点を取った. I got a really bad score on the test. 無理 means something is impossible. And the characters for this word are kind of interesting. The first character is actually the kanji character for nai, or, you know, like, ありません, like, something doesn't exist. In this character, the second character means logic. So, like, there's no logic means something is impossible, 無理. So we can say, 100点を取るのは無理だよ. So it's impossible to get 100%, or it's impossible to get 100 points on the test or whatever it is. And finally, our last word we have is baka. So I'm sure even people who don't study Japanese probably, you know, are familiar with this word. But the characters are kind of interesting. So in kanji, the first character is the character for horse, and the second character is the character for, like, deer. So a horse and a deer means stupid. And I guess the story is that a stupid person can't tell the difference between a horse and a deer. I've heard a couple stories on the origin or where this word came from. If you have your own story or if you know something, you know, share it in the comments. I'd love to hear it because I always think the ideas or the stories behind certain words and the kanji characters are really interesting. But you can also use it as a na adjective. So you can say, for example, baka na koto wo iwanaide. So don't say stupid things. So you can call a person baka, or you can say something is, you know, stupid. Baka na koto. So stupid things. Wo iwanaide. Don't say stupid things. All right. And finally, we're going to move on to our grammar now. So we have to fill in the blank again to complete the conversation between two people. The first person says, mado wo akemashou ka? Akete mo ii desu ka? Akenasai. Akete kuremasen ka? And the second person says, hai, omegai shimasu. So how do we complete the sentence here, or the conversation? Pause the video, choose an answer, and we'll check. In the meantime, I'm going to take a drink. I'm dying. All right. Anyway, so the answer is, ichiban desu. Akemashou ka? Mado wo akemashou ka? So shall I open the window? Hai, onegai shimasu. Yes, please. So for the grammar lesson today, we're going to take a closer look at how to express, you know, shall I do something? So we can do that with mashou ka. So all we have to do is just add mashou ka to the mas stem of a verb to get shall I. So we have, you know, mado wo akemashou ka. So shall I open the window? Or, you know, do you want me to open the window? And, you know, the person can say, yes, you know, onegai shimasu, please. But if we don't want to ask a question, we can just use mashou to say, you know, let's. So we can say something like, atsui desu ne, it's hot. Mado wo akemashou, let's open the window. So the only difference is here that we don't have ka, right? So the first person here, mado wo akemashou ka, is like asking, you know, shall I open the window? The second person says, mado wo akemashou, like, let's open the window, it's hot. So they're not asking for, you know, what do you think, or, you know, shall I open the window? They're just saying, let's open the window. And also, as a kind of like an extra note, if you want to ask for permission to do something, you can use te mo ii desu ka. So just like we saw in the answers, we can say mado wo akete mo ii desu ka. So like, may I open the window? So here you're asking for permission. So if you want to learn a little bit more about using mashou ka, or just mashou, or te mo ii desu ka, you can check out chapters 10 and 41 in my textbook. Goes into a little more details on how to form, you know, the mas stem, so you can make mashou ka with type 1, type 2, or type 3 verbs. And if you want to learn more about, you know, asking if something is okay to do, you can check out more information on that in chapter 41. I'll put links to those videos that I've already made in the description, so you can check those out as well. But that's going to do it for today. So as always, thank you guys for liking, watching. Don't forget to subscribe, tell a friend, and we'll see you back next time. Mata ne!